A father is three times as old as his son. Which of the following expressions describe their ages 5 years ago if the son is X years old now? Solution. We are given father and son. We are also told that the son's age is X. Father's age, we are told that is three times the age of the son. For us to get father's age, we are going to take son's age, which is X, then we multiply with 3. Therefore, father's age is 3X. We are asked their ages in 5 years ago. For us to get their ages in 5 years ago, we are going to subtract 5 from everyone's age. Therefore, son's age will be X minus 5. Father's age will be 3X minus 5. We can now say that the son's age in 5 years ago was X minus 5, while the father's age was 3X minus 5. Our correct answer is B. Galgalo, Hali, B, and Sawe shared sweets as follows. Galgalo got 6X sweets, which was 3 times as many as Hali. Sawe got 6 more sweets than Hali. B got half as many sweets as Sawe. Which of the following expressions shows the number of sweets that B got? For us to solve this question, we are first going to underline the key points. Our key point, we are told that Galgalo got 6X sweets. We are also told that this Galgalo's sweets was 3 times as many as Hali's sweets. We are also told that Sawe got 6 more sweets than Hali. B also got half as many sweets as Sawe. We can therefore solve our question. Solution. We have Galgalo, we have Hali, Bihi, and Sawe. We are told that Galgalo got 6X sweets. We are also told that these Galgalo's sweets were 3 times many as those of Hali. For us to get Hali's sweets, we are going to take Galgalo's sweets, we divide with 3. Therefore, Hali's sweets are 2X. We are also told that Sawe's sweets exceeded those of Hali with 6. For us to get Sawe's sweets, we are going to take Hali's sweets, which is 2X, we had 6. Therefore, Sawe's sweets are 2X plus 6. We are also told that Bihi's sweets were half of Sawe's sweets. For us to get Bihi's sweets, we are going to take Sawe's sweets, which is 2X plus 6, we divide with 2. When we divide these sweets, we are going to find that Bihi's sweets were X plus 3. This is because by 2 we get 1, by 2 we get 1, by 2 we get 3. Therefore, Bihi's sweets were X plus 3. Our correct choice is A. Jamil bought X mangoes and Musa bought Y mangoes. Hamina bought 3 more mangoes than Jamil. How many mangoes did the 3 of them buy all together? Solution. We have Jamil, Musa, and Amina. We are told that Jamil bought X mangoes. Musa bought Y mangoes. Amina's mangoes exceeded those of Jamil with 3. For us to get Amina's mangoes, we are going to get Jamil's mangoes, which is X. We had 3. Therefore, Amina's mangoes were X plus 3. We can now find their sum all together. For us to get their sum, we are going to get Jamil's mangoes, which is X. We had Musa's mangoes, which is Y. Then finally, we had Amina's mangoes, which is X plus 3. We can now add X plus Y plus X plus 3. We have like terms, which is X and X. X plus X will give us 2X. Then we had Y, and finally we had 3. Their mangoes all together were 2X plus Y plus 3. Our correct choice is A. In the examination, Kirui scored S marks in English, R marks in mathematics, and 7 marks less in science than in mathematics. What was his total score in the 3 subjects? Solution. We have English, we have mathematics, and we have science. We are told that in English he scored S marks. In mathematics he scored R marks. The marks which he scored in science were 7 less those of mathematics. For us to get the science marks, we are going to take the mathematics marks, which is R, we less 7. Lessing 7 here means subtracting 7. Therefore, the science marks were R minus 7. We are asked the total score in the 3 subjects. For us to get the total score, we are going to take the marks which is scored in English. We had the marks which is scored in mathematics, and we had the marks which is scored in science. English here is scored S, mathematics is scored R, and science is scored R minus 7. We can now add these marks all together. We are going to take S, we had R, we had R, and we subtract 7. We have like terms, which is R. Therefore, we are going to say that is S plus R plus R minus 7. It will be S plus 2 R minus 7. There is total marks is S plus 2 R minus 7. Our correct choice is B. Jerry bought P bananas and Atieno bought Q bananas. Sharifa bought 2 bananas less than what Jerry bought at Atieno had bought. How many bananas did all the three buy? Remember, our key point is here, where we have Sharifa buying two bananas less than the sum of bananas bought by Jerry and Atieno. Solution. We have Jerry and Atieno. We also have Sharifa. We are told that Jerry bought P bananas while Atieno bought Q bananas. Sharifa bought two bananas less than what Jerry bought and Atieno had bought. For us to get Sharifa's bananas, we are going to get the sum of bananas bought by Jerry. We had the sum of bananas bought by Atieno. Here, Jerry bought P bananas while Atieno bought Q bananas. The sum of bananas bought by Jerry and Atieno were P plus Q. Remember, this sum of bananas was 2 less the numbers which were bought by Sharifa. For us to get Sharifa's bananas, we are going to take the sum of bananas bought by Jerry, we less 2. In other words, we are going to take the sum, we subtract 2. Therefore, Sharifa's bananas were P plus Q minus 2. We can now get their sum. We have Jerry's bananas which were P and Atieno's bananas which were Q. Sharifa's bananas here were P plus Q minus 2. We can now add P plus Q plus P plus Q minus 2. We can group the like terms together. We have P and P when we had, they give us 2. P and Q plus Q to give us 2 Q minus 2. The total number of bananas bought were 2P plus 2Q minus 2. In our case, the correct choice is C. Colgate has M mangoes. Homolo has 2 more mangoes than Colgate. Wanja has 5 mangoes less than the total number that Colgate and Homolo have. How many mangoes do they have all together? We can first underline our key points. We are told that Colgate has M mangoes. Homolo has 2 more mangoes than Colgate. Therefore, Homolo's mangoes exceed those of Colgate with 2. Wanja has 5 mangoes less than the total number that Colgate and Homolo have. We can now solve our question. Solution. We have Colgate, we have Homolo and Wanja. We are told that Colgate has M mangoes. Homolo's mangoes exceed those of Colgate with 2. For us to get Homolo's mangoes, we are going to take Colgate's mangoes, which is M plus 2. Therefore, Homolo's mangoes is M plus 2. Wanja's mangoes are 5 less than the total number that Colgate and Homolo have. For us to get Wanja's mangoes, we are first going to take the sum of mangoes of both Coolgat and Omolo. Coolgat here has M mangoes and Omolo has M plus 2 mangoes. Therefore, the sum of Coolgat and Omolo's mangoes is 2M plus 2. Remember this, Wanja's mangoes are 5 less the sum of Coolgat and Omolo. For us to finalize with Wanja's mangoes, we are going to say that the sum of Coolgat and Omolo we subtract with 5. Therefore, we have 2M plus 2, which is the sum of Coolgat and Omolo's mangoes, we subtract 5. When we subtract 5, we are going to have 2M minus 3. Wanja's mangoes therefore is 2M minus 3. We can now go and take the sum of their mangoes all together. We will start with Coolgat mangoes, where he have M mangoes, and Omolo's mangoes, where he has M plus 2. Wanja's mangoes are 2M minus 3. We can now add M plus M plus 2 plus 2M minus 3. We can collect like terms together. M plus M to give us 2M plus 2M plus 2 minus 3. We have 2M plus 2M plus 2 minus 3. We can group the like terms together. 2M plus 2M to give us 4M plus 2 minus 3. Here we have positive 2 and we have negative 3. When we subtract this positive 2 with negative 3, we are going to get a remainder of negative 1. Therefore, our sum will be 4M minus 1. That is the sum of the mangoes which they bought all together. Our correct choice here will be A. Nekesa is X years old now. She is Y years older than her son. Which of the following expressions represent the sum of their ages in 10 years time? We have our key point here, where we are told that Nekesa is Y years older than her son. Solution. We have Nekesa and son. We are told that Nekesa's age is X. Son's age here, we are going to take Nekesa's age, which is X. We subtract the sum of ages which Nekesa exceeds son with. In our case, we are told that Nekesa exceeds son with Y years. Therefore, the current years of the son is X minus Y. We are asked their ages in 10 years time. For us to get their ages in 10 years time, we are going to take each one's current years and we add 10. In our case, Nekesa is X years. Son is X minus y. In 10 years time, Nekesa will be x plus 10. Sun's age in 10 years time will be x minus y plus 10. We can now find the sum of their ages. To get the sum, we are going to take Nekesa's age. We had the sun's age. Therefore, we have Nekesa who will be x plus 10 and sun who will be x minus y plus 10. We can now add x plus 10 plus x minus y plus 10. We can collect the like terms together here. We have x and x. They will give us 2x plus 10 minus y plus 10. We also have 10 and positive 10. Therefore, will be 2x minus y plus 20. That will be their ages in 10 years time. Our correct choice will be C. A group of Q girls went on a picnic. They spent P shillings each on food and a total of R shillings on transport. Which one of the following expressions represents the cost per girl? We can look at the key areas where we are told that the group of girls spent P shillings each on food. We are also told that they spent a total of R shillings on transport. We can now solve our question. Solution. We have the total number of girls. Here the total number of girls we are told are represented with Q. We have transport and food. In our case, we are told that each girl spent P on food. For us to get the total amount of money spent on food, we are going to take the total number of girls we multiply with P. Therefore, amount on food will be Q times P, which will be QP. We are told that on transport all the girls spent R shillings. Therefore, the total amount of food and the total amount spent on transport will be QP plus R. For us to get the amount spent by each girl, we are going to take the total amount spent on food and transport, we divide with the number of girls. In our case, the number of girls is Q. Therefore, the cost per girl will be QP plus R divided by the total number of girls, which is Q. Our answer will be QP plus R over Q. The correct answer in our case is A. In a cupboard, there are pencils, rulers, and books. The number of pencils is 15 more than that of rulers. The number of books is 3 times that of ruler. If the number of pencils is P, which one of the following expressions below represents the total number of items in the cupboard? we can look at the key areas in this question. We are told that the number of pencils is P. We are also told that this number of pencils is 15 more than the number of rulers. The number of books in our case, we are told that is 3 times the number of rulers. We can now solve our question. Solution. We have pencils, we have rulers and books. We are told that pencils are represented with P. Rulers, we are told that they are 15 less the number of pencils. For us to get the number of rulers, we are going to get the number of pencils, which is P, we subtract 15. Therefore, the number of rulers will be P minus 15. We are told that the number of books is 3 times the number of rulers. For us to get the number of books, we are going to get the number of rulers, we multiply with 3. Therefore, we are going to say is 3 into brackets P minus 15. When we open our brackets, will be 3P minus 45. This is the number of books. We can now find the sum of the items in the cupboard. We have pencils, which is represented with P. We have rulers, which is represented with P minus 15. The number of books is represented with 3P minus 45. We can start with pencils, where it's represented with P. Rulers is represented with P minus 15. Books in our case are 3P minus 45. We can now add P plus P minus 15 plus 3P minus 45. We can collect the like terms together. P plus P plus 3P. They will give us 5P minus 15 minus 45. We also have these dates, which is negative 15 and negative 45. When we assume these are all dates, we are going to find that the dates in total are negative 60. Therefore, the sum of the items in the cupboard is 5P minus 60. Our correct choice is 5P minus 60. Musa, Tom, and Sam scored goals for their teams during a football match. Musa scored 8 goals while Sam scored twice as many goals as Musa. Tom scored 2 goals less than Sam. What was their total score? We can look at the key areas where we are told Musa scored 8 goals. Sam scored twice as many goals as Musa. Tom scored 2 goals less than Musa. We can now solve. Solution. We have Musa, Tom, and Sam. We are told that Musa scored 8 goals. We are also told that Sam scored twice the number of goals which were scored by Musa. For us to get Sam's goals, we are going to take Musa's goals, we multiply with 2. Therefore, we are going to take 2, we multiply with the number of goals scored by Musa, which is n. Sam's goals will be 2n. We are also told that Tom scored 2 goals less than Sam. For us to get Tom's goals, we are going to take Sam's goals with less 2. Therefore, Tom's goals will be 2n minus 2. We can now find their total score. We have Musa who scored n goals, and we have Sam who scored 2n, and Tom who scored 2n minus 2. We can add n plus 2n plus 2n minus 2. We can collect the like terms together. N plus 2n plus 2n will give us 5n minus 2. Our correct choice is 5n minus 2. Angola bought n oranges and Mwangi bought n plus 1 oranges. Moheni bought twice as many oranges as both Angola and Mwangi bought. Which one of the following expressions shows the total number of oranges they bought? Solution. We have Angola, Mwangi, and Moheni. We are told that Angola bought n oranges. Mwangi bought n plus 1 oranges. Moheni, we are told that she bought twice the sum of oranges bought by Angola and Mwangi. For us to get the number of oranges bought by Moheni, we are first going to take the sum of oranges bought by Angola and Mwangi. Angola bought n while Mwangi bought n plus 1. The sum is 2n plus 1. Then we twice the sum of Angola and Mwangi in order to get Moheni's oranges. When we open the brackets, we are going to get 4n plus 2. We can now take the total number of oranges bought by the three. We have Angola who bought n. We have Mwangi who bought n plus 1, and Moheni who bought 4n plus 2. We can add n plus n plus 1 plus 4n plus 2. We can collect the like terms together. We have n plus n plus 1 plus 4n plus 2. The like terms here is n plus n plus 4n to give us 6n plus 1 plus 2 to give us 3. The total number of oranges bought by the 3 is 6n plus 3. Our correct answer is 6n plus 3, which is A. Nekesa has P pencils. Rhoda has 3 more pencils than Nekesa. Karani has 2 pencils less than the total number that Nekesa and Rhoda have. How many pencils do they have all together? Solution. We have Nekesa, Rhoda, and Karani. He had told that Nekesa's pencils are P. Rhoda's pencils, we are told that they are 3 more the number of Nekesa's pencils. For us to get Rhoda's pencils, we have to take Nekesa's pencils, we had 3. Therefore, Rhoda's pencils will be P plus 3. We are told that Karani has 2 pencils less than the total number that Nekesa and Rhoda have. For us to get Karani's pencils, we are first going to take the sum of Nekesa plus Rhoda's pencils. Nekesa in our case has P pencils while Rhoda has P plus 3. When we add, we have to get 2P plus 3. We are told that Karani's pencils will be 2 less, the number of Rhoda and Nekesa's pencils. For us to get Karani's pencils, we are going to take the sum of Rhoda's pencils and Nekesa, which is 2P plus 3. We subtract 2. Therefore, Karani's pencils is 2P plus 1. We can now find their sum of their pencils all together. We'll take Nekesa's pencils, which are P, we had with Rhoda's pencils, which is P plus 3, then we had Karani's pencils, which is 2P plus 1. This will be P plus P plus 3 plus 2P plus 1. We can collect the like terms together. We have P plus P plus 2P to give us 4P plus 3 plus 1. Finally, we have 4P plus 4. The total number of pencils of the 3 is 4P plus 4. Our correct choice is B. On a farm, there are cows, goats, and sheep. The number of goats is twice the number of cows, while the number of sheep is 25 less than the number of goats. If the number of goats is G, how many animals are on the farm? Solution. We have goats, cows, and sheep. We are given the number of goats to be represented by G. We are also told that this number of goats is twice the number of cows. For us to get the number of cows, we are going to take the number of goats, which is G, we divide with 2. Therefore, the number of cows is half G. We are told that the number of cows is half G. The number of sheep in our case is 25 less than the number of goats. Therefore, the number of sheep will be the number of goats we subtract 25. Sheep will be G minus 25. We can take the sum of the animals on the farm. We have goats, which is represented with G, and cows, which is represented with half G. Sheep is represented with G minus 25. We can add G plus half G plus G minus 25. We can collect the like terms together. G plus G will give us 2 G, then we had a half G, we subtract 25. When we had 2G plus a half G, they will give us 2 and a half G minus 25. The total number of animals in the farm is 2 and a half G minus 25. Our correct choice is A. A father shared money among his three children, Mulwa, Wangare, and Achesa. Wangare received 10 shillings more than Achesa. Mulwa got twice the amount Wangare got. If Achesa received X shillings, which one of the following expressions represents the total amount of money given to the three children? Our key areas, we have Achesa who received X shillings. Wangare received 10 shillings more than Achesa. Mulwa, on the other hand, received twice the amount Wangare got. Solution. We have Achesa, Wangare, and Mulwa. We are told that Achesa received X shillings. Wangare, on our case, we are told that she received 10 shillings more than Achesa. For us to get Wangare's amount of money, we are going to take Achesa's money, which is X, we had 10. Therefore, Wangare received X plus 10. Mulwa, we are told that he received twice the amount of Wangare. For us to get Mulwa's salary, we are going to take Wangare's salary, we multiply with 2. We have Wangare's salary, which is X plus 10, then we multiply with 2. When we open the brackets, we are going to find 2x plus 20. Mulwa's salary was 2x plus 20. We can now take the sum of their amounts. We have Achesa who received x. Wangare received x plus 10. Mulwa received 2x plus 20. We can add x plus 10 plus 2x plus 20. We can collect the like terms together. X plus x plus 2x will give us 4x. 10 plus 20 will give us 30. The amount of money received by the three was 4x plus 30. Our correct choice is A. Ali is now 2 years older than mother. If mother's age is represented by X, what will be their total ages after 10 years? Solution. We have Ali and mother. We are told that mother's current years is X. Ali's age, we are told that is 2 years older than mother. For us to get Ali's age, we are going to take mother's age, which is X, we had 2. Therefore, Ali's age is X plus 2. In 10 years time, we are going to take each one's current years we had 10. For our case, we have Hali who is X plus 2. We have Mother who is X. In 10 years time, Hali will be X plus 2 plus 10. Mother will be X plus 10. We can find their total ages by adding. When we add, we have X plus 2 plus 10 plus X plus 10. We can collect the like terms together. X plus X will give us 2X plus 2 plus 10 plus 10. 2 plus 10 plus 10 will give us 22. Therefore, their ages in 10 years to come will be 2X plus 22. Their ages in 10 years time, we can say that it will be 2X plus 22. Our correct choice is A. Wanja bought 2 kgs of peas each 80 shillings, 3 kgs of maize each 60 shillings, and 10 kgs of potatoes for 100 shillings. If Wanja spent X shillings to buy the peas, Y shillings to buy the maize, and Z shillings to buy the potatoes, which one of the equations below represents the total amount of money spent by Wanja? Solution. We are first going to list the items bought. We have 2 kgs of peas, each 80 shillings. We have 3 kgs of maize, each 60 shillings. And we have 10 kgs of potatoes for 100 shillings. From there, we can proceed to search the price per item. We have 2 kgs of peas times the price per kg, which is 80, to give us a total of 160 shillings for peas. For maize, we have 3 kgs times the price per kg, which is 60 shillings, to give us a total of 180 shillings. For potatoes, we are told that he bought for 100 shillings. We are told that amount he spent in peas was X. The amount he spent in maize was Y, and the amount he spent on potatoes was Z. From there, we are asked the total amount he spent when he bought the items. For us to get the total amount, we are going to take the sum of the prices of the items. In our case, we are told that in peas he spent 160 shillings. In maize he spent 180 shillings, and in potatoes he spent 100 shillings. Peas are represented with X plus maize, which is represented with Y, plus potatoes, which is represented with Z, to give us a sum of 160 shillings plus 180 shillings plus 100 shillings. When we had 160 shillings plus 180 shillings plus 100 shillings, we are going to take a total amount of 440 shillings. Therefore, Wanja is spent X shillings for peas, plus Y shillings for maize, plus Z shillings for potatoes, which gave us a total of 440 shillings. In this case, X plus Y plus Z is equals to 440 shillings. This is the amount spent by Wanja to purchase the items. In our case, our correct choice is A. Demo bought 2R oranges while Maua bought 4S oranges. Haifa bought 2 oranges, more than a half total number of oranges bought by both Demo and Maua. How many oranges did they buy all together? Solution. In our case, we have Demo, we have Maua and Haifa. We are told that Demo bought 2R oranges, Maua bought 4S oranges. We are now going to proceed to search the number of oranges bought by Haifa. We are told that Haifa bought 2 oranges, more than half total number of oranges bought by Demo and Maua. For us to search the number of oranges bought by Haifa, we are first going to search for the sum of oranges bought by Demo and Maua. In our case, Demo bought 2R oranges while Maua bought 4S oranges. We can proceed to search the half of the sum of the oranges bought by Demo and Maua. In this case, it will be 2R plus 4S divided by 2. It will be 2R over 2 plus 4S over 2. This will give us R plus 2S oranges. This is because we are going to simplify by cancelling to get by 2, 1, by 2, R. By 2, 1, by 2, 2S. This is now the half of oranges bought by both Demo and Maua. We are told that Haifa bought 2 oranges, more than half of this number. For us to get Haifa's oranges, we are going to take the half of the sum of Demo and Maua, which is R plus 2S. We had 2 oranges. Therefore, Haifa bought R plus 2S plus 2 oranges. We are going now to search for the total amount of oranges bought by the three of them. We have Demo who bought 2R. We have Maua who bought 4S. And we have Haifa who bought R plus 2S plus 2. We can now take the sum of oranges. We have 2R plus 4S plus R plus 2S plus 2. We have like terms where we are going to collect them together. 2R plus R, they are going to give us 3R plus 4S plus 2S, they are going to give us 6S plus 2. The total number of oranges bought was 3R plus 6S plus 2 oranges. Our correct answer is 3R plus 6S plus 2 oranges, which is A. Chepkohech has K bananas. Homolo has 2 more bananas than Chepkohech. Nekesa has 3 bananas less than the total number that both Chepkohech and Homolo have. How many bananas do they have all together? Solution. In our case, we have Chepkohech, we have Homolo, and we have Nekesa. We are told that Chepkohech has K bananas. Homolo's bananas exceed those of Chepkohech with 2. For us to get Homolo's bananas, we are going to take Chepkohech's bananas, which is K. We had 2 bananas. We can now search for Nekesa's bananas. We are told that Nekesa's bananas are 3 less than the total number of both Chepkohech and Homolo. For us to get Nekesa's bananas, we are first going to take the sum of bananas of Homolo and Chepkohech. Chepkohech in this case has K bananas, while Homolo has K plus 2 bananas. This gives us a sum of 2K plus 2 bananas. We are told that Nekesa's bananas are 3 less than this sum. Therefore, for us to get Nekesa's bananas, we are going to take the sum of Chepkohech and Homolo, which is 2K plus 2, we less 3 bananas. This is going to give us the sum of bananas to be 2K minus 1 bananas. Therefore, Nekesa's bananas are 2K minus 1 bananas. We can now proceed to take the sum of the bananas all together. We have Chepkohech who has K bananas. We have Homolo who has K plus 2, and we have Nekesa who has 2K minus 1 bananas. We can now add. We have K plus 2 plus 2K minus 1. We can collect our like terms together. We have K, K and 2K. Therefore, it will be K plus 2 K plus 2 minus 1. K plus K plus 2K is going to give us 4K bananas. 2 minus 1 is going to give us 1. Therefore, the sum of the bananas all together will be 4K plus 1 bananas. In this case, our correct choice is 4K plus 1 bananas, which is A. Karai is 8 years old and 2 years older than his wife. In 10 years' time, he will be 3 times as old as his daughter. What will be their total age then? Solution. In our case, we have Karai, we have wife, and we have daughter. We are told that Karai is now 8 years old. We are told that he is 2 years older than his wife. For us to get the wife's age, we are going to take Karai's years, which is X, we subtract 2. We are also told that in 10 years' time, Karai will be 3 times old as his daughter. We can now proceed to search their ages in 10 years' time. We have Karai who will be X plus 10. We have wife who is X minus 2 plus 10. Then we have daughter who will be X plus 10, which is the age of Karai, we divide with 3. We can now look at the daughter's age, which is the age of Karai X plus 10 over 3. This is going to give us a third X plus 3 and 1 over 3 years old. We can now look at their ages in 10 years' time. We have Karai who will be X plus 10. We have wife who will be X minus 2 plus 10. This is going to give us X plus 8. And we have daughter who will be a third X plus 3 and a third. We can now take the sum of their ages. We have X plus 10 plus X plus 8 plus a third X plus 3 and a third. From there, we can collect like terms together. We have X plus x plus hazard x. X plus x plus hazard x is going to give us 2, and hazard x plus 10 plus 8 plus 3 is going to give us 21, and hazard yes hold. Therefore, the sum of the hedges will be 2 and hazard x plus 21 and hazard yes. This will be the sum of their hedges. 2 and hazard x plus 21 and hazard yes hold. In this case, our correct choice is D. Homodi had 2 children, Tina and Hamed. When Tina was born, Hamed was 4 years old. Homodi was 10 years old while his wife was 5 years younger than him. What is their total age after 10 years time? Solution. We have Homodi, wife, Tina and Hamed. We are told that when Tina was born, Homodi was 10 years. Homodi also was 5 years older than his wife. Therefore, the wife's age was M minus 5. Hamed was 4 years old. Then Tina was 0 years. We can now proceed to search for their ages in 10 years time. In 10 years time, we are going to add 10 to everyone's age. We have Homodi, who will be him plus 10. We have wife, who will be him minus 5 plus 10. And we have Tina, who will be 0 plus 10 years. Finally, we have Hamed, who will be 4 plus 10 years. In this case, Homodi will be M plus 10, wife will be M plus 5 years, Hamed will be 4 plus 10 years, and Tina will be 10 years old. We can now take their total ages in 10 years time. For us to get their total age, we are going to take some of their ages, which will be M plus 10 plus M plus 5 plus 4 plus 10 plus 10 years. We can now collect like terms together. We have M plus M to give us 2M. We have 10 plus 5 plus 10 plus 10 plus 4. This is going to give us a total of 39 years old. Therefore, the sum of their ages will be 2M plus 39. Our correct choice is 2M plus 39, which is C. Musa bought Hex bananas and Maria bought 4 bananas more than Musa. Otieno bought twice as many bananas as both Musa and Maria. The total number of bananas bought all together was 30. Which one of the following equations can be used to find the number of bananas Musa bought? We are first going to analyze the key points. We are told that Musa bought Hex bananas and Maria bought 4 bananas more than Musa. Therefore, Maria bought Hex plus 4 bananas. Otieno bought twice as many bananas as both Musa and Maria. Solution. We have Musa, Maria and Otieno. We are told that Musa bought X bananas. Maria bought 4 bananas more than Musa. Therefore, Maria's bananas will be X plus 4 bananas. Otieno bought twice the total number of bananas bought by Maria and Musa. For us to get Otieno's bananas, we are first going to get the sum of Musa's and Maria's bananas, then we multiply by 2. Therefore, it will be x, which is Musa's bananas, plus x plus 4, which is Maria's bananas. X plus 4 is going to give us 2x plus 4. For us to get Otieno's bananas, it will be twice the sum of bananas bought by Musa and Maria, which is 2x plus 4. When we open the brackets, it will be 4x plus 8. Therefore, Otieno bought 4x plus 8 bananas. Musa bought x bananas and Maria bought x plus 4 bananas. From there, we can proceed to search for Musa's bananas, which he bought. For us to search that equation, we are first going to add the bananas which the three of them bought. We have x plus 4x plus 8 plus x plus 4. X plus 4x plus x is going to give us 6x plus 8 plus 4 is going to give us a sum of 12. This 6x plus 12, we are told that is the one which is going to give us a sum of 30 bananas. Remember, this is the total number of bananas the three of them bought. From here, we are going to leave the equation as follows because we are not going to solve until to the end. Therefore, Musa's equation will be 6x plus 12 is equals to 30. The equation is 6x plus 12, which is equals to 30. Therefore, our correct choice is A.